Hi there, everybody. My name is Virgil Ortiz. I'm from Cochiti Pueblo, New Mexico. Just wanted to say really quick thank you, NMAI, for having me a part of this symposium. And it's very exciting and informative listening to all the speakers that went before us. Good job, Karan and Kathleen. It's awesome. Okay, I just wanted to give you a quick backstory of now that I know that I've committed appropriation on myself. But I grew up in a family of potters on my mother's side, so they're all traditional potters, and that's how I started. So all of the designs that you do see on the traditional pottery, I just grew up, like, since I was 6 years old is when I started making pots. Then I really kind of started getting into fashion and seeing how I could morph the graphic imagery onto my fashion and garment. So here's an example really quick. So a sample of the traditional pottery that I do. All of the different designs have different meanings. I take from, like, my family designs, and then I tweak them and really kind of, like, Jessica was saying earlier that we really want to be real aware of what we're putting out on the internet and on the social networks, because sacred design should stay sacred and not be put on these on the internet. So some samples of my ceramic works, and you'll see how that led to a collaboration with Donna Karan. I'll just flip through these because I have a bunch of slides. So you could see how, like, the ceramic will be influenced by my fashion design, and also the fashion, like, models will influence my ceramic design too. This came from a pot that I just did a show at King Galleries in Scottsdale just on Thursday night was the opening. So I got on the plane and flew out here yesterday. But this one is talking about the LGBTQ community, and this show is called Taboo. Taboo was created. I've always wanted to talk about really hard subjects to have discussions, and, like, with all the people that do and support me and come to my shows, I picked different subjects like cancer, the LGBTQ community, suicide, gun control, politics. So these are the topics of the Taboo show that I have done. So this one deals with, like, some of my favorite musicians from the 80s, like RuPaul, Pete Burns, Grace Jones, and of course, Wewa was one of the first transgender people in, I believe, from Zuni. But the Pueblo people held them in high respect, and I just thought it was kind of cool to have combined them all together. Some more from the Taboo show. A lot of the times that my friends that are the models, I really like to dress them up and body paint them and with theatrical paintings and all the makeup that goes on, like, the stages and all the before the photo shoot. So I dedicated my life to really tell the story of the 1680 Pueblo Revolt that happened in New Mexico. There was many battles before then, but the big battle was 1680. And that is not taught in the schools. It's been swept under the carpet. It's not in any history books because of the genocide that went down when the Spanish first arrived. But, like, me growing up during the first Star Wars movie really caught my attention, and I learned all the characters and, like, what their language was, where they came from, how they looked. So I had to decide to really create a movie script about the Pueblo Revolt and tell it in 1680 and also in 2180, which allows me to bring in a sci-fi aspect to the storytelling. So you'll see, like, how all of what I'm doing right now is, like, body painting them, taking photographs, and then they eventually make it onto the pottery and then onto the garments. So it's just kind of a whole process that happens behind the scenes. These are some of my photographs with them all body painted up. And the funny story was how this whole collaboration went down with Donna Karan was, like, there's the Indian market, Santa Fe Indian market, that happens every third weekend in August every year, and it's the largest Native American art show in the world, a juried art show. And at that time, I was still doing fashion shows back then, and I believe it was, like, a Sunday. I did it on a Saturday night or something, and everybody had fun and partied late. So in the morning, on Sunday morning, I got a phone call, and again, I thought somebody was prank calling me. But it was Donna Karan on the other line. So she was saying, like, can I meet you, or can we do lunch? So I said, okay, like, who's doing a really good prank? I got up, took a shower, and I went to go meet her at my store. And lo and behold, she came in and she said, I would like to do a collaboration with you. Like, here's my silhouettes. And like, her assistants had all kinds of binders of all her latest, of her 2003 spring line. So she was all like, what would you think of putting your designs onto my silhouettes? So that's how it all started. And next thing you know, I was on the plane out to New York, working with them with all their designers. So it was pretty cool to have that experience and for her to mentor me and to show me the whole process of, like, from the beginning of the designing point to all the sales, to the fashion show, to the parties afterwards and everything, like, with all the, how to deal with the press, that helped me a lot. And it was like going to FIT, like, in a matter of 2 months. But that helped me a lot with my own fashion line. So you can just see again, like, how my photographs of real people influence my ceramics and vice versa too. So you'll see how they transfer to all the designs on my leather handbags, pants, and silk scarves. Duffel bags, more scarves. Muscle. But this is a from my label called Made in Native America. And it's like my little duty, what I'm doing. All my products are made and manufactured in Los Angeles. So it's just my little point of, like, keeping the manufacturing here in the States. So everything from the garments to the zipper holders, the zippers themselves, the buckles, all the leather, everything is made in the United States and manufactured, packaged, all here. Some more of the fabric from, inspired by from the pottery, transferred to dresses. It's the whole collection, how I started off with my red spine collection. I first did them all in black. So we have card holders, phone holders, the duffel bags, iPad holders. Then we started adding, once it grew, then we started adding the color to them, also in different textures. So it just grew and grew, and all of this whole process I learned from the Donna Karan collaboration. It just keeps growing and growing. The more you add to it, like, you, the more you sell, the more you're able to support the whole line and just keep going from there. This was some of the press that we got when the 2003 spring line hit the runway. So we had to do interviews with Vogue magazine and all the different fashion magazines around. And this particular dress on the right-hand side is in the Native Fashion Now exhibition. When we first released the show, Donna Karan had allowed me to redesign her whole flagship store on Madison Avenue. And I was like, are you sure you want me to do that? But it was, she said, yes, you can do it. So she sent out, like, maybe 10 mannequins. You could see the one way in the corner. So I pre-painted all of these, like, with all the designs and what I thought a mannequin would look like. So she said, okay, the whole front of the store is yours. You can do whatever you want. So that's what happened. And along the ways, I was like, wouldn't you be interested in doing home furnishings too? And she said, of course, like, duvet covers, all this. So that was born really quick. And she brought her own bed from her house to the to the store. That was pretty exciting because once we had the opening at the store, she let me do my own video, have a pottery show so I could put them right next to the actual pieces, the garments, to educate the fashionista crowd about where the designs came from. And we went to go do the fashion show, and right after the fashion show was over, we went back to her apartment, and all the home furnishings was moved back to her apartment, like, in a matter of, I don't know how long, an hour. And the photo shoots came, and we had driven out to Palm Springs, and my friends were unloading the artwork into a house in Palm Springs where they're having the photo shoot. And he comes back out, and he was like, you're never gonna know who's modeling your pieces right now. And he didn't tell me, but until we got into the gate, and it turned out to be Mila Jovovich, one of my favorite actresses and models. And got to hang out with her and just watch the whole process of how a huge photo shoot for a big campaign like this goes down. So there is a way to collaborate with these huge brands. My advice to all of the up and coming native designers is to do your homework, learn all the process of how a successful collaboration can happen. And that goes down to protecting your intellectual property, to trademarking, copywriting, spending money on that. It's expensive, but in the end, you protect yourself in case you get entangled in an appropriation kind of situation, you're backed by what you're protecting yourself with. So that's like one of the most important things, how to do it, is to learn how to play that game, because a lot of people, whatever you put out on the internet, it's gonna be snatched up right away. So if you're not careful, just know what you're doing and what you're getting into. And like I said, there's a way to do a successful collaboration, and I'm living proof of that. And it's just like a God-given thing when a person like Donna Karan is able to mentor somebody like one of us. And I've just been happy, been lucky to be that person that she chose. And now, like, I want to like offer like any of the other designers that are coming up too, if they want to ask questions or anything about me and how the collaboration work, I'm willing to help them do that, just because I find that it's really important for them to protect what they're putting out there. That's when I had my wig on. You know, like how many years ago? And then I go to sleep with my ceramics. But thank you guys for all this, and enjoy it.